Namaskaram and hello to all our viewers everywhere. Welcome to our channel In Conversation with a Vagyekara with Guru Garu Sriman Nallan Chakravarti Murthy. This is your host Kiranmay Ganti. Today is episode 10 in our series. Wow, 10 episodes. Thank you for watching so far. As we have begun our discussion in the last two episodes with another concept of Varnams as conceived by Sri Murthy, it's called Bhavaraga Tala Varnams. We will dedicate one more episode into a deeper discussion of these kind of Varnams. As we've been discussing how Sri Murthy's Varnams are, they have in general taken a different dimension in terms of thematic lyrical content, as was also explained in detail by our Guru Garu. Even though these Varnams are verbose in nature, they are quite rich in melody. And surprisingly, they do not compromise on the rigor that is needed in singing a Varnam. And in Bhavaraga Tala Varnams, the content, the lyrical content is extended to another level because these lyrics have a deeper meaning, whether it be philosophical, whether it be of devotion, submission, of love. The topics vary, but the lyrics are rich in these aspects as well. So, you know, I was always wondering, how is it possible with so much heavy in lyrics, and how is the bhava being able to being conveyed in the constraints of a varnam? These are what we will be discussing today. So let's bring in our Guru Garu. Namaskaram, Guru Garu, and welcome to the channel.
Hello.
Hello, Namaskaram. Welcome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. I was just telling our audience we have been discussing your Bhavaraga Tala Varnams. We're focusing on another episode into detailed discussion of this for this one, about the rich lyrical content in your Varnams, but how bhava is being embedded in it by staying within the rigor structure of a Varnam. So you have explained a little bit, but can you throw a little bit more light, a little bit more detail in that, please?
Yeah, see, there is one more thing also which I would like to mention. Mm-hmm. In general, all my compositions, whether it is a Varnam or a Kirtana, when it is made in a particular raga, mm-hmm. the lyrical content has a close relation to either the name of the raga mm-hmm. or the kind of emotion it evokes. Mm-hmm. You know, generally there is a belief that this raga evokes this kind of emotion and things like that. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you something more about it a little later, but mm-hmm. Whatever is apparently felt by majority of the section of people, and the great belief prevailed in most of the people that a raga has a particular rasa. Mm. So we will just confine ourselves to that at the moment.
Okay.
My compositions are always having a relation with the name of the raga or the emotion it is believed to be evoking. Okay?
Okay.
For example, okay. If you talk about, say, Ananda Bhairavi, Ananda, divine bliss, okay? Mm. Although it also has a connotation of the romance. Mm-hmm. Now, you have ragas like Kafi and Natakuranji. They also have a relation to giving the emotion of romance, okay? And things like surati, you know, you remember, you know, that kind of saying, Adi Nata Anche Surata.
Okay? I heard from you. I didn't know that, but yeah.
You begin with the Nata, your concept with Nata, and then with surati, okay? Now, surati is considered Mangalaprada. Mm. You know, if the people go with a little bit of satisfaction that they have heard a good concert.
Mm.
So that is a kind of feeling which everybody has.
Mm-hmm.
but to tell you frankly, I don't subscribe to this view.
Okay.
That is, I don't subscribe to the view of a raga creating only one rasa.
Mm.
A raga can create any rasa. This is not a popular belief, but this is a misunderstood aspect that a raga creates only one rasa.
Mm.
It is not right. See, it can create any rasa. It depends upon the composer who manages the phraseology and the lyrical content so that that bhava is created. So therefore, we should not believe that a raga will create only one rasa. It has all the rasas.
Perfect.
Okay? Now, anyway. but at the moment, as I said, you know, when I am taking some of these examples, I will confine to one particular rasa in which it is already written. Okay?
Okay.
Now, for example, you know, I mentioned about Andhravairavi, Kafi, Ramadakuranji, and Surati.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? There are other ragas also. There are about 32 ragas in which I have made this Bhava Raga Talam. Okay?
Mm.
Each has its own mood or emotion creating.
Mm.
There is one interesting aspect, you know, when we study these ragas. Mm-hmm. Particularly, the ragas like Anandabhairavi and Kafi, mm-hmm. you know, both are janyas under the Karahanapriya.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And both are Bhashanga ragas. Bhashanga ragas means there are some Anyaswaras coming, right? Okay?
Anyaswaras are swaras that are not in the Murchana, in the Arohanam, in the general.
They are not there in the Melakarta. From which it is derived.
Okay.
In Bhashanga ragas, some of the extraneous swaras, anyaswaras as you call, anyaswaras are also sometimes reflected in the Murchana. But here, you know, you will find that. In Anandabhairavi and Kafi, these are not reflected. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Mm? And one more very interesting aspect is, both are Karanapriya Janyams, but also the kind of Anyaswaras which are there are also the same, either in Anandabhairavi or Kafi.
Or Kafi.
It is Gandharam, Antara Gandharam, Shuddha Devatam, and Kakal Nishadam.
Okay.
So these are the three Anyaswaras coming in both the ragas.
And now, yet they produce such a different flavor.
That is the interesting point. Mm. Both are Kara, they are Janyas of Karaharpriya. Both are having the same kind of Anyaswara. But at the same time, the flavor is entirely different.
Vastly different, yes. We have dealt with so many examples. Which one would you like to take up today, Guru Garu? Since you were talking so in depth about Anandabhairavi and Kafi, would you like to take any of that today?
We will dwell with this aspect of this similarity, etc., at a later stage when we take up a different subject. We are at the moment confining to this Bhavaraga Talavarnams.
Okay.
Let me take one example. Let us say in Kafi. Since Kafi is interesting raga.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm.
Not that the others are not interesting, but
yeah. we take one example to start and explain in it.
This has a different flavor altogether and can create a number of moods. And most important among them is the romantic mood.
Mm. Okay.
It has been used in the light music. It has been used in the film music also.
Film music, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, extensively, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So therefore, to have the popular belief continued, I have also made a composition, this Varnam, in the romantic mood itself.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Now here, the lyrics go like this. A heroine or gopi thinking about Krishna. Okay. That is the usual concept, you know, which is a very popular one.
Yes.
And when you talk about romance, you know, that is the thing which automatically comes into your mind.
Yeah. Krishna, okay. Radha, Krishna, Gopikas.
Mm. So this gopi sitting in an isolated place and thinking about Krishna. Yantati moham maye. Yantati moham maye. Marantani sairyutune. Yantati moham maye. Marantani sairyutune. That is her state of mind. Okay? Now, she suddenly remembers Krishna doing many things and not fulfilling his her wishes. Vintalinno kesiva he is despaired of. He has been talking about so many things, making so many kind of dialogues, but at the same time, he always is eluding. Vintalinno jethivadintaku darijerede paltamele jeyu a Madana Gopala Murti. Why is this fellow so much adamant? Tamele Jeyu A Madana Gopala Murti. After all, I am looking for some happiness from him. Santa Tami Radilene. The usual style of ladies trying to find fault with the men. Madana Gopala Murti Santa Gama Garita Rinita Magarita Riparita Ripagari Rinita Bagari Ripagarita Now, one thing which should be understood in any Varnam, when you have this Pallavi and Anupallavi, the following Muktaishwaram should also reflect the same kind of feeling which has been there in the Pallavi and Anupallavi. That is one thing very important. And the Charanam and the Charanaswaras, when you have, the Charanaswaras should reflect the same kind of spirit which is there in the Charanam. Okay?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So, Gamagaricha, Nicha, Magaricha, Marutani, Chayiltuni. What will this fellow will lose if he comes to me and gives me some happiness? But So that is the spirit which is conveyed in the first part, the Pallavi and Anupallavi and the Bhutta Hesha. Then when you come to the Charanam, Talale ni virajatapamu intati biguvelano. Talale ni virajatapamu intati biguvelano. Re nipa gari ri sari mapani. Virajatapamu intati biguvelano. Like that. Papa Magari Panita Maga Magari
Anyasaram.
Guru is coming. Papa Magari Panita
Maga Magari
Rima Panida Nirimani Pagarita. Allah, the Karanpia Nishadamundi. Rima Panida Nirimani Pagarita. Papa Magari. Now. See, this is another interesting point is Sa and Pa are considered Achalaswaras. Many people believe that there will not be any kind of Dhamakam in that. Now you look at here. Pa Pa Panita Maga Magari Pa Pa Magari Panita Maga Magari Pa Pa. Now you are giving a Dhamakam to Pa. That is the beauty. Pa pa magari panita maga magari rima panida nirimani
pagarisa
rima panita rima pa chani panita gari pagari chani pa pagari chani pagari rima panita lele mi viragata intati biguvelano. Last Charanaswaram is very important. Nitari chani pagari chani pagari nitari pani pagari chani pagari rimagari chani pamapa nitari chani pagari chani pagari rimagari chani pamapa Rima panidani padani nitapa. Rima panidani
padani nitapa.
Magamani
padani nitapa.
So that is the beauty of this Kafi Ragam and use of this Anyaswaram. Nipagarimi. Here comes a very peculiar prayogam. Sarigari Sarigama. Now, Sarigama Prayogam is not possible in according to Murchana. Sarima Panita, Saridani Pamagarita. But some of the oldest Padams, etc., they carried this kind of Prayogam. Riga sariga ma riga ma gama gama riga rima gama sama gama ripa gari ni tari sariga ma gari ta ma gari ta pa ma gari pa gari ta sariga ma gari ta gama gari ta like that. So that particular prayoga I just wanted to incorporate and remind people that this is one of the oldest traditions.
Oh, wow. That is so beautiful.
Writers. Nipagari ni tarigari tarigama.
Sarigama.
Nimabari.
Nimabari.
Nimabari. Nimabari. Nimabari. Nimabari. Nimabari. Nimabari. Ma ga ri ta ni 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 Bhigu velanu. So that it's many facets of the Kafi Raga, which are sometimes even forgotten or have been incorporated to this Varnam. So fortunately, somehow my brain has been activated by him. He includes some of these programs.
So beautiful, so beautiful. I'm sure many of your Varnams and many of your compositions are also geared towards bringing out some of the hidden or forgotten aspects in our Carnatic music. And
many things like that. I think we will discuss at this stage.
Different topics.
When it's complete. Now, at this stage, in this raga, I just wanted to show that this is a forgotten prayoga. Yeah. So like that, there are many aspects in Carnatic music.
Yes.
We'll talk about it when we come to that particular aspect.
True. Thank you so much for explaining so much detail. In so many of your compositions, I guess I'm looking forward to further discussing and further shedding light on other things like this. And viewers, I hope you have enjoyed the scintillating Kafi Varnam from our Guru Garu. I guess that's it for today. If you have any specific questions on Ragams, different compositions of Srimurthy or Carnatic music in general, please do send in your suggestions in the comment sections. And please like and share and subscribe to this channel. For now, we would like to conclude today's episode. See you all hopefully in the next episode. Namaskaram and goodbye.